Tim Lane from ABC Sport. Now, you probably think that clean living sporty types like me are usually at home in bed at this hour of the night. And you're right, we usually are, but not always. I'm here tonight for love, not money. The ABC's making no penalty payment, but I get the chance to watch in action the Daly Wilson Big Band. What you're about to see is a program made at the ABC's Gore Hill studios in late 1982, just about a year before this band finally broke up. The program was made to celebrate 13 years together for the Daly Wilson Big Band and 25 years as professional musicians for Warren Daly and Ed Wilson. It's a summary of the band's significance to Australian jazz. It includes their trailblazing tour of the Soviet Union in 1975. And you also see early appearances of now prominent musicians Vince Jones and James Morrison. Let me read to you from the Oxford Companion to Australian Jazz by Bruce Johnson about the Daly Wilson Big Band. They were the most successful jazz-based big band in post-war Australia. They provided a performance workshop in which scores of young musicians served an apprenticeship well before the establishment of the Jazz Studies program at the New South Wales Conservatorium. The band also provided the setting in which many important performers, both in jazz and more commercial areas, received increased exposure, such as singers Kerry Bedell, Ricky May and Marcia Hines. Now, I have to make a confession. I know more about sport and television than I do about jazz. But as a lover of sport, I can really appreciate the teamwork here and the great skills of the performers. And as a person involved in the making of television programs, what I really like about this is the appreciation it does give you of the individual components in what's a great group effort. So sit back, lie back, and enjoy the Daly Wilson Big Band.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome to the show. My name's Warren Daly, and the other fella in the pictures at the top of the show, of course, was my partner, Ed Wilson. I must say that arrangement you just heard was originally composed by the great Bob Florence, and it's also his arrangement. We love playing that. It's a very special arrangement to us. It's one of the trickiest in the book. We're celebrating 25 years in music, Ed Wilson and myself, this year. And collectively, we've also had the Daly Wilson Band for 13 years. And we've had some pretty special moments happen for us in those times, and we'd like to share them with you tonight on this show, together with some of our more famous arrangements and probably the most exciting stuff we've got. So have a listen to this one from Willowcrest. We're going to take you down the road of the blues, basically blues. And that was basically blues, and it was originally composed and arranged by Phil Wilson. As I was saying before, we've had many exciting moments over these 13 years that we've been together. And I guess talking to Ed earlier, we decided that one of the real highlights was when we went to Russia. And that came about as the first agreement reached by the then Prime Minister Gough Whitlam back in 1975 for a reciprocal arrangement between the Soviet Union and Australia to swap jazz artists and, in fact, many other musical identities. And we were luckily the first to go. We travelled right through the Soviet Union, including Lithuania and Latvia. And it was a pretty wild time, I can tell you. The Russians are probably about the most avid jazz fans we've ever met in our lives. It was just amazing that they actually turned out 5,000 per night, and the scalpers had a real good time too. Would you believe that they do have them over there? And they were charging for the latecomers $100 per seat, and that's a fact. So they're pretty into jazz over there. Which brings me to the occasion to show you a film that we actually decided to present. It's pretty well a landmark for us, that trip to Russia. So we're going to show you a little film clip that was made in the Tractor Hall of the People, would you believe, in Leningrad. Have a look at this. It's the band back in 75 playing Strike Up the Band.
Сегодня у нас в гостях впервые приехавший на гастроли в Советский Союз австралийский оркестр Daly.
We played 20 concerts ever in Russia, and all of them turned out to be 5,000-seater venues, and it was quite a thrill. That footage, incidentally, came by way of a Russian camera crew in combination with the ABC at the time from here, which flew over with us. I don't know if you noticed or not, but the personnel looked decidedly different in that footage to what you see on the stage with us tonight. And that's been the case. We've had a turnover as every big band in the world has over the years. Personnel come and go, and personnel, in fact, come back too. There's one fellow that I want to draw special attention to that was in that film that you just saw. In the front row was a lead alto saxophone player that stayed with us right from the very outset. He was a foundation member. Doug Foskett is who I'm speaking of. He stayed with us for 10 years on a permanent basis, and the last couple of years on a casual basis. And the contribution he made to the band was something that I'd defy anyone to improve on. He was a marvellous lead alto player, and we're going to play now a tribute to Doug. Angel Eyes is the name of the tune, and our latest lead alto player, Tony Hobbs, is going to pay the tribute on our behalf to Doug, who sadly died just a few weeks ago. Tony Hobbs with Angel Eyes.
Thank you.
And that was, of course, Ellington and his famous Take the A Train. Over the years, Ed and I have been very fortunate in being able to produce and show off to the Australian audiences varying degrees of talent in the vocal stakes. And we hit the jackpot with a number of them. We introduced to concert hall audiences right around Australia many singers, but three stand out in my mind to date, and they were Kerry Bedell, Ricky May, and Marcia Hines. We've also been very fortunate to come across a fellow who's making a lot of noise down in Melbourne. When I say a lot of noise, he's attracting a lot of attention because he's a great talent. He's a fellow that's come out of Melbourne and he's now emerging as a real jazz force in the world. For the first time, I'm happy to introduce, with the Daly Wilson Big Band, from Melbourne, Mr. Vince Jones. Vince Jones, and I'm sure you'll be hearing a lot more of him in the near future. Mm-hmm.
You may have stayed all through the night. You may have come and gone into this presentation of jazz through the night on ABC television. Whatever way, I hope you've enjoyed it. I certainly have. And I hope that we'll meet again. It may be on ABC Radio, it may be on FM, it may be on Radio National. But whatever way, I'm Jim McLeod, and I wish you happy days. Bye now.
This is a Brisbane band. They're known as Bebopera. Tonight they're playing with Lee Cottrell. For those who are in Sydney, you'll be able to see them this week, all week. Say hello to Bebopera.
For you, my love, I'd do most anything. I'd do most anything. Well, I love you, baby, and I hope you feel the same. For you, my love, I'd swim the ocean blue. For you, my love, I'd swim the ocean blue. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do for you. Oh, and let's go out tonight, celebrate. I got a party planned for you that just won't wait. For you, my love, I'd do most anything.
Part of the evening where, as they say, anything can happen and usually does. Here they are, Chorfest.